Welcome to the 2019 Midwest AC Regional Croquet Tournament, sponsored by the United States Croquet Association and the Centennial Lakes Park Croquet Club in Edina, Minnesota, where the tournament is being held. Our tournament director is Mike Weimerskirch, and this is the final of the draw portion of a draw-in-process tournament. Rick Sheely and Tom Balding are playing for that final at those relative AC grades. Tom is also in the final of the process after squeaking by yours truly, 25-26.
12-23.
Tom Balding opens east boundary. Tom is a senior at St. John's College this fall, and that's where he learned to play croquet. He played his first AC tournament, I think, last summer, so he's been playing AC less than a year. He is definitely the new kid on the block. Rick Sheely, his opponent, has been around for a long time. He and Nate Weimerskirch are the locals who play on these lawns all the time. I've seen Rick use this response before. It is a little vulnerable to having the third ball just set up in corner two. And Tom, in shooting at it from corner one, is going to accomplish the same thing if he misses. It just leaves the fourth ball no double target to shoot at from B ball. As you may have noticed, I'm doing very little editing because Tom's pre-shot routine is so short and his style is so fluid that there's really nothing to cut out. That's a little unusual. Most folks would have done a full roll to have those balls close together down by the boundary, so it's easier to guarantee no double target. So, Tom Balding opened with blue, won the opening, and on the fifth turn with black, made nine and laid a standard diagonal spread. The black clip is on four back. All the other clips are on hoop one. Rick's thinking about trying to make a double out of those two balls or shoot at him from corner three. And the disadvantage of shooting at the double and missing is that the on-time triple is there for the taking. And, of course, he couldn't take partner to hoop one because the peg ball is not easily rushable to hoop two. Thank you. I don't think why we would call this the Monte Carlo style of play, but it certainly is aggressive. What he may or may not lack in precision, Tom makes up for with absolute fearlessness. He has yet to complete a standard triple, but he did have a TPO, of all things, against Jeff Sue a couple of months ago. Ah, yes, that precision thing. You can see where the balls are. The black clip is now on penult. The blue clip is on six. Yellow and red are both still on hoop one. And now in turn eight, Rick Shealy tries to get something going. That was a spectacular rush. Black is for penult. Thank you. Black's on Rover, blue's on six, red is on one, yellow is on two. Dangerous amount of follow through for that hampered shot. Yellow is still down by hoop one and will serve as a so-so pioneer for two back. The safe thing would have been to roll both of his balls over toward the east boundary and try to get a rush on red back to one back. But when you can shoot like that, who needs to do the safe thing? Lots of croquet lawns seem to be near major airports. inching towards the Rover Peel. So, Peg and Peg for blue and black, and hoop one for red, and hoop two for yellow. And there is a lift. Twenty-five to one. A lot of games have been lost in this position. Guessing that the red ball is about twice as far from the blue ball as the peg, should he shoot at the peg or that ball? If you care to see my analysis, it's tacked on to the end of the video. Thank you. So Tom Balding wins the draw portion of the tournament. 26-1 over Rick Sheely. The analysis about whether he should shoot at the peg or the ball is as follows. The length of the shot on a ball that's equivalent to the length of the shot on a peg is a function of the relative diameters of the two. Since the peg is an inch and a half in diameter, the ball is 3 5/8. You take the ratio of those two diameters, add 1 to it, and divide that into 2. The conclusion is that if the ball is less than 40% beyond the peg, you shoot at the ball. And then obviously peg out with 2 shots. If the ball is greater than 40% beyond the peg, then the peg is an easier shot and you should shoot at that. This, of course, does not account for which shot is guarded by an opponent ball, how much wind there is, or what the terrain conditions are. But if you have a 13-yard shot from the long boundary on the peg and the ball is more than 18 yards away, you ought to shoot at the peg. I use this in my basement, shooting at a golf ball to simulate the 17 or 18-yard shot. Thanks for watching. Give us a like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and check out the rest of the videos in this series to see what else Tom Balding is up to in the Midwest AC Regional Croquet Tournament.